Hi guys, and welcome to my very first video. Today we're going to talk about how to get a job in the fashion industry with no experience. And this video might be useful for the recent graduates from fashion schools, or maybe you don't even have an experience in the fashion industry at all. Doesn't matter what your case is, I think my 5 tips can be useful for you. And before actually getting into the video, let me present myself. My name is Vasi, and I have more than 3 years of experience in the fashion industry, and I have studied and worked in Milan, Paris, and I'm currently based in London, where I have worked for luxury brands like Burberry, and now I'm working for a smaller brand. My biggest tip ever before actually apply for any role is to do your research. This is really key. So I use websites like Fashion Jobs, LinkedIn, Business of Fashion, and go on those websites or any local websites that are used in your area and see what jobs are out there. Of course, this would be easier if you're living in a fashion capital like Paris, Milan, or London, and there would be a lot of jobs popping up, especially during fashion weeks. But even if you don't, I'm sure there are some stores or some smaller brands in your area that are also looking for people. So go out there and check what people are they looking for, and then go on those job descriptions and have a read. See what are those people actually doing, because there are so many departments within the fashion industry that I had no idea when I started. And after you have figured this out, you can more easily apply for an internship after. And apart from an internship, I think a good position that you can get with no previous experience is in retail. So check the positions in retail that are open, and one very key thing is actually to apply at smaller brands. So when we start, when we all want to work at the big fashion houses like Louis Vuitton or Chanel or Prada, and to be completely honest with you, when I first started applying, I was desperately applying for Gucci. Maybe I applied to every possible internship that was put out there, and they didn't call me for even one interview, and I was feeling so bad. I was asking myself all the time, oh my god, what am I doing wrong? Why are they not calling me? But the reality is, it's so hard to get in those fashion houses that even getting an internship there, you need a previous experience to get to this internship. So don't be like myself, don't push yourself too hard if you don't get it. Apply for smaller brands, and you just have more opportunities and likeliness of actually getting a position there. It's time to get your CV and portfolio ready. Tip number one, and this is really key. Forget about any resume templates like Europass or any of those that you can find online. There is just no way that you can get a job in fashion with one of those. Now, this is a good point that you can express your creativity and your skills through your resume. Make it with Photoshop, do it with Illustrator or any other program that you know how to use, and it will make you stand out. Now it's a good time to use it. And I don't want to go too much into detail with this because I'm thinking of making another video, but if you would like to apply for sales, make sure that you include keywords within your resume like I hit sales target, or I know how to work in team, I'm a team player, or I'm proficient in Excel or in Photoshop, or I have used Shopify for 3 years, or whatever it is. Just make sure that you actually include it within the resume, because big brands like Burberry, for example, or any of those big fashion houses, they receive thousands of resumes for every single position. So before actually a person reviews your CV, there is a software that scans your resume and it's looking for those keywords that are in the job description. So it might be in sales, it might be Excel, it might be InDesign, anything. And if it finds those keywords, then it will actually get to the HR. So there is also a big chance that if you're not including those keywords, your resume is not even being seen. So please keep this in mind, and this is why I told you in the previous step that it's important to do your research so you know what are those keywords that you should include. Okay, so you have your CV ready, and now it's time also to prepare your portfolio. So this is of course more relevant if you're a fashion designer, but also if you're working in marketing or in any other department, it's good to have some type of portfolio. And you should include there any projects that you have. And I'm sure that you will have those from school that of course you should include, but if you have something maybe a little bit more commercial or something that you have done from a friend of yours that just started their fashion brand, actually those things that might be more useful, because the truth is if you actually go as an intern in a fashion brand, they wouldn't give you all this freedom and creativity that you have expressed in your work. So maybe focus more on the commercial side. So now that you have your portfolio and resume ready, now it's actually the time to send applications, but you should send customized applications, and customize here is really a key word. So now you have, let's say you have found the very specific job in e-commerce that you like. And what you should do, you should go on their, first of all, company's website and go into the about page, read what are the values of this company. Go also to their LinkedIn page and read what they have shared with other people. So this is what the brand wants you to know about them. And check the value proposition, check their competitors, do also your research before applying to this job. And once you have done this, you have to include this into the cover letter. So when you're writing the cover letter, you should say that you have done your research, say why you like this brand, and make sure you also highlight why you're suitable for this role. At this point, look for jobs that have very specific skills and qualifications that you might have. This might be a language, you might speak Chinese or French or German, anything. Or maybe they're looking for someone that has a lot of social media experience. Then this is your time to shine. Even if maybe in the beginning you weren't really considering one of those roles, you actually might have better chances of getting one of those just because you have one of those key skills and qualifications that they are looking for. So maybe also try and apply for those. Step number four is actually not to be afraid to stand out of the crowd. So as I said, we now live in a digital era where we can send so many applications and it comes like almost automatic. You can send maybe thousands of applications within like 2 hours if you want to. However, it is still important to make everything very personal, as I was saying before. And okay, what I'm going to say, it might sound a little bit scary, but trust me, it will pay off. So what you have to do is print out your CV or portfolio or maybe both, and send it out actually to the brand. Check where their office is. check what person is the team manager that you would like to work for. Check the manager, check the team, check someone that it's actually in there. You can find all this information in LinkedIn. I know it's a little bit stalking, and I know you're not really supposed to be checking this, but it doesn't really matter. I mean, no one is actually going to judge you for doing that. So print those, get them ready, and send it to the brand. I mean, of course, say also why you're doing it. Say that you're very interested in this role, that you would really like to get it. And again, this is a good time also to include the cover letter as well. Every time that I have even messaged someone, a manager from the team, for example, when I'm looking for, let's say, something in wholesale, and if I find who is the wholesale manager in this company, and I write to them in LinkedIn saying, hey, look, I have just applied for this role, and I'm very interested, and I wanted to express further my interest, and here is my resume or whatever. And every time, the least that happens is that it gets me to an interview. So again, there's nothing you can lose, just get out and do it. Or I also have friends that have gotten jobs through actually printing their CVs and physically going to the office of the brand. So step number 5 is actually to apply. Keep on applying. And I'm sure you will get a lot of rejections. We have all been there. Stepping your foot into the door, I think it's just the most difficult and hard part within like the whole working in the fashion industry path. But you just have to keep on doing it. Don't give up, even if they reject you, even if they reject you once or twice after the interview, it doesn't really matter. Because at least you got the chance to speak to those people. The important thing is, after you get this to this interview, to have some feedback after that, and to use it so you can build and work on those skills later on. And I think this is it in a nutshell. Please comment down below actually what is your dream job in the fashion industry, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more videos like that. Hope this was helpful for you all. Bye!